AMD's latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors are officially released, and you've got questions. I can tell by that look on your face. The reviews online haven't exactly been great, but does that mean you actually shouldn't upgrade, or is that just tech tube being tech tube? Well, whether you're a streamer, content creator, or gamer, we'll help you figure out which of these new CPUs is the best fit for you and your setup. And if you're wondering whether it's worth upgrading from the something like the popular Ryzen 7 7800X3D, we've got you covered there as well. My name is Devin. Welcome to the Pixel Pub. Cheers to AMD for having a semi-successful CPU launch. Yeah, cheers either way. Let's start with a really quick overview of the Ryzen 9000 series lineup. AMD has released four new CPUs in this series. I'm gonna put them all up over here. We've got the Ryzen 9 9950X, 16 cores, 32 threads, priced around $650. The Ryzen 9 9900X, 12 cores, 24 threads, priced around $500. The Ryzen 7 9700X, 8 cores, 16 threads, right at about $360. And the Ryzen 5 9600X, 6 cores, 12 threads, priced at right about that $280. Now these CPUs are built on AMD's Zen 5 architecture, bringing higher clock speeds, better power efficiency, improved performance across the board. But which one of these is right for you? Let's break them down really quick. Let's start right at the top, the Ryzen 9 9950X. Who exactly is this for? Really, this being the top of the line at $650, the target audience for this is going to be absolute power users who need top tier performance, heavy multitasking, 3D rendering, video editing, other really heavy core intensive tasks. Now, when we talk about cores and threads, what exactly does that mean? When it comes to a computer that you're using for gaming, streaming, video production, and things like that, think of the processor of the computer as the brain. The amount of cores it has is the amount of different things that it can multitask doing at any given time. Most games are very single core oriented. So as long as that single core speed is up there, you don't really have to worry about having as many threads as possible. But when you're doing things like running Discord, Spotify, OBS, as well as your game and all of those other applications that go along with streaming or video editing, sometimes a couple more cores can help. Now with 16 cores and 32 threads, this CPU is an absolute beast for production workloads. It's ideal for content creators who need to chew through really, really large video files, but honestly is probably going to be overkill for most people. If all you want to do is stream your game, have Discord up, and play that game at the same time, the only reason I would recommend the 9950X is if you've got some extra money laying around and you really want to future-proof yourself. The Ryzen 9 9900X has a much more balanced approach to its high performance in both gaming and productivity. With 12 cores and 24 threads, this is going to be a really solid CPU for most content creators. This CPU is going to be able to handle any game that you throw at it with high settings, obviously depending on what your graphics card is, but it strikes that probably better balance between cost effectiveness, amount of power, and versatility and clock speed to get you to be able to do what you need to do. Now let's jump down to the Ryzen 7 9700X, and this is going to be a lot more in line with Intel's i7 lineup. This CPU is going to be more in line with just gamers, or maybe those esports focused streamers that don't have a ton of processing power going into their games. With not a shabby 8 cores and 16 threads, this CPU is going to be great for gaming and light content creation. It's going to be able to handle your streaming. It's going to be able to handle your video editing. But when it comes to the price, you get what you pay for. 8 cores and 16 threads is going to do that amount of work. It doesn't have the same core count as the 9900X, but it still handles most modern games and streaming applications just fine. Jumping down to the Ryzen 5 9600X, This is definitely going to be targeted at gamers more on that budget that still want really solid performance. With 6 cores and 12 threads, this is going to be the most budget-friendly option in the 9000 series lineup. It's going to be great for gaming and your basic applications. It's going to be able to do your video editing, just not quite as fast as some of the other processors. Now, you might be asking yourself, how do these new CPUs stack up against the Ryzen 7 7800X3D, which has been a favorite among gamers for a very long time now? The 7800X3D still holds its ground as one of the best gaming CPUs, particularly due to its 3D V-cache technology. In gaming benchmarks, it often matches or outperforms the likes of the 9900X in terms of FPS per watt, making it still probably the best choice if your primary focus is on gaming. But when it comes to multitasking and productivity, the Ryzen 9 9950X and 9900X are gonna offer better for performance in multitasking and productivity tasks, thanks to the higher core counts and the better efficiency from these processors. If you're doing more than just gaming, like streaming, video editing, or even running virtual machines, these new CPUs offer a significant upgrade over the 7800X3D. Now, if you already have a 7800X3D and are primarily gaming, upgrading might not be necessary, unless you really need those extra cores for multitasking. However, if you're working with an older CPU or find that your current setup lagging in production tasks, the new 9000 series offers a compelling reason to upgrade. Now, there are some valid reasons why some people aren't liking the 9000 series processors so far, but from what I can gather, the biggest majority of people that are really not liking these processors are the people saying that the power improvements are so minimal that they're not going to be making a difference if you have a 7000 series Ryzen CPU. To be completely honest, I don't think that these processors are made for people that are upgrading from the 7000 series though. The biggest improvements have been made in the power consumption department, using less than half in most cases for the exact same amount of power that you're getting out of these CPUs, I think is an engineering marvel, but some people aren't quite happy with that because they're not seeing the massive jumps in FPS in their games. So in the grand scheme of things, if you're okay with paying a little bit less for the processor, a little bit more for the power that it takes to run that CPU, you are probably okay with getting one of the older 7000 series processors. The nice thing is the 7000 series processors are still on the AM5 platform, so I have no problem recommending them as they'll still be upgradable with the same motherboard for well into the future. If you're looking to do some gaming, you can't go wrong with the 7800X3D. And if you are looking at streaming video production stuff, you might consider the 7950X. It's still a great option for the price. All right, so let's break the 9000 series down with a couple of real world recommendations. For most gamers, I would probably stick with the Ryzen 7 7800X3D if gaming is your main priority. It's still one of the best CPUs out there for pure gaming performance, especially if you can find it cheaper than any of these other processors. Consider the Ryzen 7 9700X if you want that slight upgrade in overall system performance without completely breaking the bank. But if you are a streamer or a content creator and you want the newest and the best possible option out there, I think the sweet spot is the 9900X. If you want to be able to game, stream, and do that content creation, it's going to offer the best balance of price to performance for those needs. The Ryzen 9 9950X is that powerhouse for those who want the top tier performance for rendering, editing, heavy multitasking, but honestly is going to be overkill for most. It's really hard to recommend the Ryzen 5 9600X at this point in time. It's going to be just fine for your gaming, but it's really hard to recommend it just based on the price alone right now. Once we see some good discounts and sales on that processor, it's gonna be a really, really good one in the coming years. Now, as always, prices will stabilize, go on sale over time, and if your current setup isn't holding you back, waiting might be a good idea to see exactly how things evolve right now. But instead of waiting, if you are interested in that Ryzen 7 7800X3D build, I put together a full build with that PC right over here if you're interested in checking that one out. It's a pretty solid build, if I do say so myself. We'll see you over there.